subject to weekly renegades. Deacons meeting after service today. Bill and Moshe Kerr arrived home safely and sent aloha. Hallowed be thy name, October 31st. Prayer request goes out to Kepa, Kanapore, Ohana, Julie Rabbi catching up on her personal affairs, John Kalahoy Jr. recovery, Tammy Harikai treatment, Jonathan Stockton recovery. Are there any more announcements that anyone would like to share with us this morning? If not, Nani, we'll call to worship.
Let us begin our worship service, everyone, with our call to worship. Join me in both the Olelua Kohime and the English, and we will do our Nahimene following our call to worship. And you can find our Nahimene on page 27 in a Nahimene Puke. Uapono ka inoa mai ka'i. Let us begin with our call to worship. If you can, we ask that you please stand and give praise and glory to God. Let us begin. He nani ko wahi noho I ke apua ka haku. And the word said, how lovely is your dwelling place of hosts. And let us begin our nahi mene.
Lord willing, maybe we can get Taui in the future. Maybe Makala, if you could reach out to Kaui and just see kind of where he is with his maybe. Poma is the one, right? We set up with Taui. Kruger. Is that right? Taui Kruger.
Yes.
Yeah, maybe we just touch base with him. Like, I know his heart is to come and help us learn these songs well. So we'll maybe we can touch base with Poma and see if he can. And they take those little Bibles that are like the plastic cover, and they have Psalm, Proverbs, and the New Testament. Or they have the big Bible that they put in every hotel in the whole country. And they even have an international outreach. And the reason why they chose the name Gideon is what I wanted to teach the teaching today. Gideon was a judge of Israel. And he was a timid man. He was a man that was not naturally brave. But God called him. He's the one who said, Lord, if you are with me, then let the fleece be wet and the dry ground, and then the ground be wet and the fleece be dry. He gave God this almost like a test to say, God, if you're with me, if you want me to go into battle, then show me that this is a sign that you're with me. And God showed him how to confirm his word by fleecing in that respect, to say, Lord, when I wake up in the morning, if the ground is dry and the fleece is wet, then I will know. And then after that, he said, okay, I'm going to give a further sign. This time, I want all of the ground to be wet and the fleece stay dry. And that's even a greater sign, right? If the whole ground is wet, surely the fleece would be wet too. But God made that thing bone dry. And then Gideon went down to the river, and God said, you are still too many for this army that I want you to raise. And when you go down to the river, the ones that put their face down to the river brook, they are not going to be the ones who fight for you. But rather, it's going to be the ones who take the water up to their mouth and they remain watchful. And they drink like this. It says, those ones. And what was the number of Gideon's army? 300. Out of thousands that he could have raised from every able-bodied young man, God chose 300 mighty warriors. And God taught the Israelites at that time that he wants his soldiers to be people who stay alert, who are watchful. They're wise. They're not people who shrink back and who don't know the situation. You see, this is true for our spiritual life. We have to take care of our needs, physical needs, but we also need to remain watchful. We need to remain observant, that there's an enemy all the time ready to attack. And if we just go down to the river because we're thirsty and put our head down and maybe he shoot an arrow at us. But if we keep our weapons by us and we go down by the brook and we bring the water up and we remain vigilant, there's something about that the Lord said, those are my soldiers. Those are the ones who are going to fight for you too. And God took these little number, 300 people, and he went and he, boy, he kicked us not out of the other enemies of Israel. But 300 people. Some of the armies were in the thousands, but those 300 were so tuned in to God's strength and God's wisdom, so that when God came and taught them how to fight, he would give them a great victory. Isn't that a cool story? So these guys, these Gideon, they said, hey, we're going to be like that. We're going to take the truth of that call that God has given us. Come on, Jordan, come on. We're going to take the truth of what Jesus told, or sorry, what God told there of Gideon, that when you go down to the river, I want you to observe those soldiers that are being watchful. Those will be the 300. Those will be the ones who are my soldiers. And God did a great deliverance to Gideon, judge, and those 300 Gideon soldiers. So that's what this Gideon thing is about. They said, we'll be the Gideons in our generation. We're going to make sure that all of the churches, all of the hotels, all of these different places, they're going to have a Bible there. And there's so many incredible testimonies about how people were in a really rough time. They were traveling, and they reach into that hotel drawer, and what do they find? They find the Gideon Bible. And the little symbol on the Bible, I want to show it to you after church, is a man with this little flame. And it's that picture of Gideon, of being the faithful soldiers of the Lord. Okay? So let's go ahead and pray that into our inner child, into our KP, and pray for their protection. And I pray that our parents will be like Gideon and Gideon's soldiers as well. That we remember that we're not just here to be the
Father, we thank you that you have knit them together in the womb, that you brought them into this world for the time that they live. Father, we thank you for this youth ministry, the young adult ministry we had last night, Lord. We thank you for the time of worship and praise. We thank you, Lord, that they're learning to go after the face of God, to cry out, to learn to pray to you, Father, individually and as a group. We thank you for the time of worship. We thank you, Father, for the testimony. We thank you that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb. Father, we thank you that you're doing something special and unique in these young people. And Lord, I pray for your protection and your provision over our safety. And Lord, I pray that all the parents would be wise like Gideon, that they would know that you are with them. When the fleece is wet, the dry be brown. The brown be brown. And when the fleece is dry, the brown is wet. Father God, you do these incredible things. You show us that you're with us. And Lord, I pray that we be watchful, that we would be wise, that we would know how to protect, to fill the needs of our community, but also to remain with you. In Jesus' name. Thank you.